means I got the name of the game myself, but oh well, I don't have time to fix it, I already figured it out. RIP! I'm late. And then I got the name. So, that cake. That beer bottle that's not working. Can't find the other. My sword. Oh yeah, I'm gonna get all kinds of bob muted. I meant to name it, how many bob mutes could I get? Music-wise.
Don't get me wrong, I love you. What does that mean? I have to meet
my Switch, so I wouldn't have. Apparently, that's not the key. Still have it. Every adventure ahead of you, vows to encounter friends, unfolds through melodies and memories. Some of these adventures take place in field battle music stages. With these stages, you battle enemies as you draw on a musical staff, reach the end, and play the song. You use different buttons to attack, jump, use abilities, and have your actions as the timing guides that show exactly when to press a button. The outer circle will gradually shrink. Aim for the moment, it lines up perfectly with the inner circle. That wasn't my practice round. Gonna tell me the buttons this time? Did that already. Hey, I'm getting it. Jump. I know I did bad, but I don't want to replay the tutorial. I need to recover. Oh, my mic is like a mile away, that's the problem. It's like, why isn't my mouth moving correctly? Right, it flopped over earlier. Not the chance to fix it. Is that better? Yeah, that's a little better. Alright, your HP decreases every time you miss. If you reach the end of with some HP, you clear the song. Enemy enemies require multiple attacks to be defeated. The number above their timing guide tells you how many times they hit them. More tips and tricks, more tutorials and help in the config. Yeah. I the world in song to get started. When controlling the gummy, shift press B to return to the main menu.
Let's do it. Buttons confused. Or unlock certain keys. Okay. Change the difficulty and set items to use before starting the song. Use L and R to select difficulty, beginners, easiest, and honest numbers. Press A to set potions and other items to use as quickly as you play. Right. If that last one was the beginner that I did that on, I think. Sounds doable. Well, they're mad now. They're angry. guess.
Led by a mysterious voice, Sora stepped through the door that marked the start of his journey. Sora, Riku, and I wanted to see the world beyond our island. One day, Sora came face to face with a man from another world. Meanwhile, Donald and Goofy received a letter from Mickey asking them to find the holder of a certain key.
To summarize the plot. I hate that I'm a beginner, but I know I can't do anything higher. I can get an excellent on the finale. I'm getting worse. Yeah.
Wow, 55, Gene. I guess maybe because I know that song a little better. I could get into it more. Hey, Brush!
One fateful night, darkness consumed Destiny Islands. As Riku disappeared into the darkness, my heart managed to escape to safety inside Sora. The darkness overwhelmed Sora, and he awoke in an unfamiliar town.
I'm gonna make this.
so angry.
Having been chosen by the Keyblade, Sora teamed up with Donald and Goofy. The trio traveled together through many worlds, locking the world's keyholes in order to keep them safe from the encroaching darkness. Meanwhile, Riku awoke in the dark depths.
Oops, I didn't skip it. I hit a button right as it ended.
Come on.
can't stop doing it. Or I guess it's just this point, not late.
Thank you.
an egg. Versus battle. Yeah, no thanks. I think sometimes it pities me and gives me. I think there's one world where I'm gonna have to mute it entirely because. I know Disney's gonna swoop in. Hello? That's our song?
We'll be right back.
I remembered a little while ago that my audio desyncs after a certain amount of time, so that's going to be interesting for this, so I'm trying to get used to following the purpose of the music. It's kind of what you're supposed to do. But I'm not good at these. One I'm not sure. There's no lyrics, but I'm sure, I don't know, I'm sure the melody is still close enough that it's gonna get bad muted. But I don't know what to say through it. I'm doing bad enough as it is. Not talking through it. Here I go, trying to talk through it. I don't know what to talk about. I wonder. definitely didn't talk enough, but didn't know what to talk about, and I was trying to focus. I guess this song incites such a reaction from people because the battle mechanics were so bad in it long ago. That in the orchestrated thing we did, where it's like, here's all the battle music, everything. Okay, complete means all the missions. Let's do Colosseum. Oh my god. I hate Colosseum music. I hate it. I'm so sick of it. We'll be right back. underwater music in there too. No underworld. I am with me. Unless it reappears for possible. Leaving Neverland for last because it's my favorite.
Thunder!
box is rolling. Goofy is fucking dead.
Thank you.
remix version of this. Yes, I love this one.
We'll be right back.
Sounded promising too. Interesting.
With his heart clouded by darkness, Riku stood in Sora's way. As they fought, Sora realized that his power came from his friends, not his weapon. When Sora found out that my heart had been inside him all along, he saved me without sparing a thought for what might happen to him. Now it was my time to save him. As I wished for that strength, something incredible happened. Hoping that we would never be separated again, I gave Sora my lucky charm.
Yeah, what a beat to get down to.
Thank you.
battle music stage. In boss battle music stages, you face off against boss characters in a rhythmic battle. Side targets, stick, full targets, press and hold, ability press X. Targets with a line connecting them need to be hit at the same time. Hit the targets, hit and hold targets, press as many of them as. Slide, tilt both the left and right sticks. Left and right. The hold target will be right when another one ends. Change which button you press to. Oh boy. Well, let's see. More boss battles than just final bosses.
The light emanating from Kingdom Hearts destroyed Ansem, the strongest darkness Sora faced. But the darkness behind the door still threatened to burst out at any moment. With Riku and Mickey on the inside and Sora on the outside, they sealed Kingdom Hearts from both sides. And so, Sora and his two friends continued on their journey.
Music stands. Team you use does not work. I only played Chain of Memories like one. It was re-Chain of Memories.
Thank you.
Sora continued his journey in search of Riku and Mickey, and found himself at Castle Oblivion. Using cards made from memories of the worlds they'd visited, the group continued deeper into the castle. Meanwhile, Riku awoke beneath the castle and was met by a mysterious voice. With Sora headed for the top floor, and Riku aiming for the ground floor, the two continued to climb, each on their own path.
Struggle. Funny how the game assumes I change screens. Like, nope.
As Sora advanced through the castle, his memories started to fade. In exchange, new memories of Naminé grew clearer. It quickly became his goal to save her from where she was being held captive in the castle. Meanwhile, Riku was fighting the darkness within himself as he continued through the castle. Lying in wait to confront him was a boy who looked just like him, a replica of himself created by the organization. This replica was planted with false memories that caused him to stand in Sora's way.
Yeah.
Naminé had the power to overwrite the memories of Sora and those connected to him. The organization used this power for their own gain. Even after discovering the shocking truth that his memories of Naminé were fake, Sora still chose to protect her. He prepared for the final battle, eager to finally retrieve his lost memories.
Sora's a good boy. This is a nice recap. Regular one.
The battle at Castle Oblivion came to an end. To regain his memories, Sora would have to forget all about Naminé. He fell into a deep sleep, but not before leaving himself a reminder to thank her when he woke up. Meanwhile, Zexion decided that Riku had outlived his usefulness. From within a shroud of magic, Riku heard Naminé. Riku accepted the power of darkness without fear, and he used it to defeat both Zexion and the replica of himself. Naminé offered to use her powers to lock away the darkness in Riku's heart for good, but he refused, choosing instead to wield its power as his own. Riku and Mickey set out from Castle Oblivion, continuing along the path where darkness lies hidden within light. The road to dawn.
Alrighty.
We'll be right back.
in Twilight Town, Roxas was supposed to be enjoying his last week of summer vacation. But he kept having dreams about Sora. And all sorts of strange, unexplainable occurrences started happening around him. Roxas ended up at an abandoned mansion, where he remembered that he used to be a member of Organization 13. He also learned that the world he knew was a fake one set up by Diz to restore Sora's memories. With one day left, Roxas's summer vacation was over.
It might be an early shorter stream because starting late.
Thank you.
Sora finally awoke and found a message written in Jiminy's journal. With some guidance from Mickey, he set off to continue his journey once more. Sora felt his heart grow heavy as the train carried him away from town. At the tower, Yen Sid warned him about Organization 13. Mickey had set out to learn more about the organization. Sora, Donald, and Goofy searched for him, again visiting different worlds.
Why is the Neverland music so good? Kingdom Hearts 1 and Birth by... Oh wait, this wasn't actually good.
Thank you.
Here.
Oh yeah, this would have made sense for the D's team. And we're actually at 358 over 2, but... wait.
Seven days after Roxas was given a name and a place in Organization 13, he encountered Number 14, Shion, and the gears of fate began to turn. The organization was made up of nobodies, those without hearts, and their goal was to complete Kingdom Hearts in order to become whole again. To achieve this, the Keyblade that Roxas held was an indispensable tool. As the days passed, Roxas completed his missions. Along the way, he became closer friends with Axel and Shion. The organization had another goal as well, the creation of replicas. They had copied Sora's scattered memories and powers from Castle Oblivion into an artificial replica, resulting in Shion. Riku found out that this is what was keeping Sora from waking up. And Shion was distraught to learn that she was nothing more than a puppet. Axel did what he thought was best for everyone. And Roxas left the organization to find out who he truly was. Shion was determined to return her memories to Sora, so she paid a visit to Naminé. As she neared completion as a replica, Shion asked to be destroyed, and she wanted Roxas to be the one to do it. Trusting Roxas to set free the hearts they'd collected, Shion returned to the place she belonged, inside Sora. Roxas headed for the organization's castle, but Riku blocked his path. Upon learning that Roxas was Sora's nobody, Riku unleashed all his powers of darkness to defeat him, paying no mind to the cost. Roxas awoke, ready to start a brand new day of summer vacation.
What a confusing order to put this. Like, it's nice to get a summary, but if somebody was really trying to use this as a summary to, like, get into the games, what a weird order to put.
this somehow. Say we do this world and then call it a night. Seems like a good stopping point. About where I would stop if I were really playing Kingdom Hearts 2 because the intro was so long. Thank you.
I don't want versus battle. A specific way to leave? What can I do? So many. You don't realize how big Kingdom Hearts is until it's like laid out in front of you like that. Alright, so is this autosave or what? Yes, sir.